Generally speaking, it is advisable to keep the number of arguments as few as possible, both in your daily life and when programming. There are, however, times when you might want to have a large amount of arguments. From personal experience, this often occurs on Reddit, or when working with different UI-related things. Having a lot of arguments means that it can quickly become difficult to know what each of them do. Not only that, but you might not need all of the arguments all of the time. This can lead to a situation where you still need to set all of them in order to reach the last one. We will take a look at a couple of different concepts which will help us deal with this. Named arguments will make it more clear what each argument actually does. Default values will also allow us to omit arguments which are not needed, reducing the amount of arguments that we need to pass in. Let's imagine that you have a class which is responsible for creating some UI element like a text box. This constructor takes a whopping 9 arguments, and when we actually instantiate it, you will see one of the resulting problems. It can be difficult to know what the arguments stand for. Example, the position and dimension arguments look very similar. The same goes for these two booleans. To avoid this kind of confusion, certain languages have a feature called named arguments. The idea is that you pass in the name of the argument as well as its value. This is something which we can emulate in Lua. Instead of passing in the arguments one by one, we can instead pass a single table, which contains all of them. I will name this argument settings. Then we add settings in front of each of the arguments when we assign them to the instance variables. When we pass in the arguments, we need to wrap them in a table. Next, we add the names of the arguments and set them to equal the value. For example, x equals 200, y equals 300, width equals 300, and so on. Another benefit of passing in a table is that the position of the arguments no longer matters. This is especially helpful when you have a lot of arguments and can't remember the exact order they are supposed to be in. With the use of the OR keyword, we can add default values to our instance variables. If, for example, the settings.x argument was omitted, then it would be equal to nil. Lua will, in this situation, choose the value on the other side of the OR, in this case 0. Let's continue adding some default values to the rest of the variables. There is an interesting problem which occurs if you set the default value of a boolean to be equal to true. If it was omitted, then everything will work as intended and the variable will be set to true. The problem occurs when you specifically pass in the value false. Lua treats false the same way as it treats nil in this situation, so it would pick the true again. There are a couple of ways to solve this, the most simple one being to add an if statement which checks if the argument is nil. Then, and only then, should we set it to equal true. Now it will be false if we pass false, and true if we pass true or omit it. Another way would be to use a short circuit evaluation, a concept which is a topic for another video. A third way would be to set it to equal the comparison not equal to false. If we pass in true or nil, well, that is not equal to false and therefore will be set to true. If we pass in false, then this comparison will result in false. While this way requires the least amount of code, I feel like it looks deceptively simple, which could lead to misunderstandings. However, this is the beauty of code. You can do one thing in a lot of different ways, and you should pick the one that makes the most sense to you. Since we now have default values, we can go ahead and remove the arguments which only pass in default values. For example, the width and height, the shadow, and the outline arguments. As you can see, our function call is both more verbose and has fewer arguments. I think you can agree that it's a lot easier to see exactly what we are actually passing in, relative to the code at the start of the video. You know what else has fewer arguments? People who like the video, subscribe to this channel, and join our Discord server. Well, come to think of it, if you do join our Discord server, you may actually have more arguments, but do it anyway.